So you've embedded your YouTube videos into your website. And when someone is viewing those videos, they get to the end of the video, what happens? Do they see someone else's videos? Do they see competitors' videos? Do they see inappropriate videos? Or do they see your videos recommended to them? Those are the two options, and you as the website owner get to choose. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to choose option number two, showing more of your videos. So this is something that YouTube changed around 2019. It used to be that if you use this little trick, it would show no videos at the end of your video that's embedded into your website. And just to be clear, this does not work on YouTube. This is solely for YouTube videos embedded into your website. Now, what they're doing is if you use this little trick, it will only show more of your videos. So much better than showing your competitors or something inappropriate, but I'm gonna dig right in here over on the computer. So this is what we're trying to prevent. So I got to the end of this video and it's showing a bunch of random videos. This is on my website and I'm gonna fix this one today. Let me show you what it should look like. This is one that I've set up properly. It only shows a series of my videos at the end. So let me go back over. I'm on my website now and I'm gonna go in and do the edit. So here with me, I do enable Visual Builder. Your website might be a little bit different. So let me go in here and I'm going to edit this block. Here I use the little cog icon. And really what we've got here is I inserted this as a video and it doesn't work, at least in my software. You have to insert this as HTML code. So with most website software, there's a couple of different options as to how you can put a video into your website. One is to just insert it as a video. Maybe there's a little option to say, I want to put in a video and you just throw in the URL to YouTube. Or you can maybe even just drag and drop the YouTube URL. And that doesn't work here. So what you need to do is use the second option, which is to insert the embed code. So to get the embed code, you need to go over to YouTube and find the video that you want to embed and then click the share button here. And you can see this is just the URL that you could drop in if it was just a video, but we need to go here to embed and then copy out this code here. So I'm going to click the copy button, copies that, and we'll head back over here and I'm actually going to delete this block out. And I'm going to add a new block. Like I said, each one of these, they'll be a little different for depending on your software, but I'm going to choose to embed HTML code. And then I paste the code in. And then I need to modify the code. So it's pretty simple. At the end of the YouTube /embed/ the bunch of characters, just add a question mark, lowercase rel, equals zero. And that's before the end quote. So it looks exactly like it did before. I'm going to exit Visual Builder and save. And like I said, there's a number of different ways, but the key here is for whatever software your website is running on, you need to be able to edit the HTML for this. Okay, so now if we come over and play this video, and I'm going to go right over to the end. And boom, you can see here now it is only sharing my video. So the key there is to add that question mark rel equals zero, so related videos equals zero inside the HTML code. So the final question that I have for you is, why are you embedding YouTube into your website? Are you doing it for the right reason or are you doing it for the wrong reason? So there's options of YouTube versus Vimeo, both really great platforms for sharing videos. Both have their superpowers, and one of the superpowers of Vimeo is being able to embed into the website really well. So I've got a video up here which explains the different powers of YouTube versus Vimeo and why you should be choosing one over the other. I'll see you in the next video.